Right, let's talk about policing pro-Palestine marches. They're very much the topic on the table, have been now for a week since they beamed from the river to the sea onto the Houses of Parliament. But policing these marches so far is costing more than £25 million.
You know what? I would say no beep, Sherlock. The fact that all of a sudden some Home Office reports this, which has cost us quite a lot of money turning out the entire Met Police to make sure these people don't do tonto things, that means the police can't do other stuff. You don't say. You don't say that. That's what the general public obvious, have been thinking when they shut down the whole of Tower Bridge. When every single police officer is taking selfies with someone with a, you know, ISIS flag instead of, you know, doing their job. You don't think the public haven't noticed this? You had to come out of a report and be like, oh, it's costing a bit of money. It's putting unsustainable strain on the police. We know.
Yeah, well, look, there's the police not stopping pro-Palestinian marches blocking Tower Bridge at the weekend. You know, 25 million. They spent £18 million apparently in December alone. But I'd like to know what they're doing with this money, because I've been to these marches. The cops just stand around looking at them. They don't actually do anything. They don't actually arrest anyone. So why does it cost that much money?
Oh, the problem we've got, though, is you can't put the genie back in the bottle, because this wasn't nipped in the bud. Now, if retrospectively Parliament has a debate about this, they won't, because they'll debate language instead. But if they had a debate about this and went, do you know what? Yeah. Considering we've got to have bodyguards for our MPs, the police are now completely broke because they have to turn out every week to deal with this rabble-rousing mob. Yeah. Let's stop the marches. It's too late now. They won't stop.
I've seen these couple.
You can't tell these people to stop now. It's done.
Our problem here is the police are pro-Palestine. That is a big problem. Talking of kind of the same issue, Charlotte Church, you like a sing song, don't you? So everybody,
like
get clicking, tap your toes. Let's have a listen to Charlotte Church singing From the River to the Sea. It's a real good tune. Here we go. Take it away, Charlotte.
Clarify my intentions there. I am in no way anti-Semitic. Fighting for the liberation of all people. I have a deep heart for all religions.
Let's have a look at this one.
This, the first clip you saw was actually the follow-up single from her new album, which is arguably more tuneful than that first
one. Well, let's have a listen to that again.
Just to clarify my intentions there, I am in no way anti-Semitic, fighting for the liberation of all people. I have a deep heart for all religion and all difference and... And it was a beautiful, beautiful event. But unfortunately, the powers that be can't have that. Can't have such a powerful symbol of resistance as what we worked towards on Saturday. And we sang lots of other beautiful songs, lots of other songs of liberation and freedom, Arabic songs, Welsh songs. South African songs from the anti-apartheid movement, which were the lyrics which were adapted to the situation in Palestine.
Yeah, what she sang was a genocidal hate song about obliterating the Israeli state, so Israel doesn't exist, and annihilating Jewish people. That's what she sang. That is not a song of unity, Charlotte, and you are an anti-Semite. Got it?